Good morning. Let me first thank all of you for coming to this press conference. What I'll do is to make a short statement first, then after I'll be happy to take your questions. This presidential election is an important one. The past few years have seen unprecedented changes in the global financial system and in world politics. Many institutions reveal their weaknesses. There is much work to be done, internationally and nationally. I believe that the next president of Singapore may have to make very significant decisions that will affect the security and well-being of all Singaporeans. 5 years ago, I stepped down from politics after serving 27 years as a minister and a member of parliament. I'm presently very comfortable with my status as a private citizen. In Singapore, I am fully engaged with my duties and responsibilities at GIC, SPH, and NRF, the National Research Foundation. Outside of Singapore, I serve on the boards of several private and educational organizations. So why would I risk all this? Stimulating and interesting work, and a legacy built up over three decades to embark on an independent, possibly risky bid for the presidency. The answer is simple. How could I not run? How could I remain a spectator while Singapore faces such complex challenges? How could I not step forward when I know that I have more to contribute to the country we all work to build? I remain convinced that Singapore's best days lie ahead of us. The years ahead will be challenging but exciting. In the midst of so much change, we need a president with experience and a steady hand. And so, after much reflection, I've decided to announce my candidacy for the office of president to serve Singapore and Singaporeans once again. If I'm granted the certificate of eligibility, I will contest as an independent candidate. I have resigned from the PAP. There is no legal requirement for me to resign from GIC or SPH. However, to avoid the appearance of conflict of interest, I have decided to resign from GIC with effect from 1st of July. I will also resign from SPH with effect from 1st July so as to remove any doubts about SPH media's independence. As regards my non-executive position in NRF and other boards, I will take leave of absence to distance myself from their daily operations and to concentrate on the election campaign. If I am elected president, I will be fair and independent. I will work in partnership with the government, all political parties, and civil society to safeguard and advance the future of all Singaporeans. As I said, Singapore's best days lie ahead of us. If we remain united and respond with creativity and energy to the challenges ahead of us, our country will continue to progress and thrive. Together, we can build a better and more fulfilling future for all Singaporeans. Thank you. I'll now be happy to take any questions that you may have. I'm running as an independent candidate. My candidacy does not have the backing of any political party, and I'm not seeking such backing. There have been some reports which I've read in the press which suggest that I am a government-endorsed candidate. I'm proud to have served the people of Sembawang and Singapore for 3 decades. But the government did not approach me to run for the elected presidency. It was my own decision. Given my current position as Deputy Chairman and Executive Director of EIC, I did inform the Chairman of EIC, who happens to be the Prime Minister, of my intentions to contest the elections and to resign from EIC as a matter of protocol. I have stepped forward as I believe that this election is an important one, coming at a time when the next president is likely to see great change nationally and internationally. As I said earlier, I believe that we need a president who is fair and independent, but who can also work in partnership with the government, all political parties, and civil society to safeguard and advance the future for all Singaporeans. Okay. Another question. Yes.
Zakir from Straits Times.
Yes.
Dr. Tan, what would your response be, say, if the Labour movement or activists associated with a political party were to offer their backing and support for your campaign? But also, your association with the PAP goes back a long way. Do you view it as an advantage or as a possible stumbling block, perhaps?
Well, first of all, of course, if the Labour movement or other associations or business groups or other groups in Singapore would like to offer me their support and endorsement as the preferred candidate for the presidency, then I'm of course very grateful for such endorsement, and I welcome them. I've made it clear that I'm not seeking the backing of any political party, but obviously as a candidate, I welcome support from all quarters. I have been involved with the government and with the party for over 3 decades. It has been a fulfilling experience. I am proud and happy to have been of service to the people of Singapore and particularly to the people in Sembawang. Whether that will be an advantage or disadvantage for me in the presidential elections is a matter for the people of Singapore to decide. Yes. Any further questions?
Hi, Dr. Tan. Elliot from The Online Citizen. Do you believe in a Singaporeans first policy in which jobs and universities are reserved for Singaporeans first? Do you believe in a Singaporeans first policy in which jobs and universities are reserved for Singaporeans first?
Singapore is an international city. We will not progress by closing our doors and making it difficult for international talent to come to Singapore. But having said that, of course, our primary responsibility is to Singaporeans. We must give Singaporeans and their families every opportunity and assistance to advance in their careers, in their jobs, to have a fulfilling life. And I believe that it is the duty of the government and all groups in society to try and make this possible. Yes?
Dr. Tan, my name is Yining from MediaCorp. Could you elaborate on the kind of difficult decisions that you expect the President to have to make in the next few years, and how do you hope to be able to steer Singapore and lead Singaporeans through these decisions? Thanks.
Yes. This is an important question. We are in difficult times now. The last few years, 2009-2010 have been very difficult years. In 2008 and 2009, we were on the brink of another global depression similar to that of the 1930s. Fortunately, the worst of the global financial crisis is behind us, but recovery is not an overnight or straightforward affair. Countries all over the world are still grappling with hiccups. They need to reform institutions, and Singapore is no exception. The same is true for Singapore. There will be very difficult decisions we have to be taken by the government, by Singaporeans in the coming years. And it is here that I believe that my long-term perspective and my experience in both the public and the private sectors can benefit Singapore and all Singaporeans. Politically also in Singapore, we have seen many changes over the past few years. I believe that the president can play an important role representing Singapore internationally in a diplomatic but non-governmental capacity, and at the same time to serve as a unifying figure in Singapore at home to heal divisions, both political and economic, and to advance the future of all Singaporeans.